author Sarah M. Broom, whose new memoir, The Yellow House, takes us on a journey, and a remarkable journey, through New Orleans, especially New Orleans East, exploring her beloved childhood home that was destroyed by Hurricane Katrina. Her tale, it's one of love, loss, and resilience. She's going to join us in a moment. Let's take a look at her story first.
The Yellow House was witness to our lives. When it fell down, something in me burst.
After Sarah Broom's childhood home was destroyed by Hurricane Katrina, she was inspired to rebuild in a different way.
How to resurrect a house with words.
This is Sarah's mission in her new book, The Yellow House. Sarah grew up in New Orleans East, just 7 miles outside of the French Quarter.
New Orleans East is not a place you find on most of the tourist maps.
Today, Sarah is reclaiming the narrative of her city and her home.
Houses provide a frame that bears us up. Without that physical structure, we are the house that bears itself up. I was now the house.
Such profound words. Please welcome Sarah.
Thank you.
Okay, full disclosure, we were having dinner in her home in Harlem several months ago. She said, you know, I've written this little book. And I'm like, oh, well, send me an advance copy. I read it. I'm like, amazed by it. And then boom, but it took 8 years.
Eight years. Years.
It was a labor of love, wasn't it?
It really was. And it was important for me to get it right, Robin. Mm. This was a place my mother bought when she was 19 years old in 1961 with every cent she had. Mm. And so I had to do justice to the world that she built. You know, I'm the baby of 12 children.
12? I know, right?
So she raised 12 human beings inside of this house. And when I was growing up, there were no stories of New Orleans East. Even when I was reporting this book, mm-hmm. there weren't reference books. I wrote the book that I needed and that I wanted my nieces and nephews to read.
You have like 50 of them, don't you?
I have so many. What? Nearly 50 of them.
Right. And hopefully that they'll add to the story.
That's
right. It really
right.
inspires families. And I'm inspired now learn more about my family history. And, you know, when you hear, yes, there's no place like home, and it's the details. You know, sure. A house is a house, but what makes it a home to you?
You know, for me, it's beauty. That's the thing my mother taught me, is that you figure out what's beautiful for you, and then you go out and you collect beauty. That no matter what you have, we can all train our eyes upon a beautiful thing and get immense joy from it. And so for me and where I live, I'm always collecting beautiful things. And even if they don't match or they don't go.
I didn't want to say that, but when I was in your home, I was like, that doesn't go with that. But it was so warm and inviting. It was you, it's you.
Sure.
Okay, it's August. And those of us who are from down south, and we have some folks in Mississippi and New Orleans, 14 years ago, Hurricane Katrina. And your home was destroyed by that. And then later was completely demolished by the city. You recently were able to go back. When you went back and just saw that lot, what was in your mind, in your heart when you saw that?
You know, Robin, it was a profound feeling. When I went back, the only thing left that I could recognize was a single cedar tree that my father had planted before I was born. The rest of the lot was just green grass growing. And I thought to myself, it was the first moment I understood why I wrote this book, because I thought, oh, this book tells the history of a place no one except me or my siblings can see. And so for the kid who still lives on the street where I grew up, she will have a record, a history of what came before.
Yeah. And what is your message? What does you want people reading this? What do you want them to have? The message to come away with?
Sure. I think for me, it's really about what it means to love a place. That if we truly love a place and are tethered to a place, then it's our job to get to know that place, to think of that place, and to look beyond the official map, to not only go to the places that are in the narrative, but to go beyond those places.
Well, thank you for taking us on.
Thank you.
Because as you will read, people outside of the family weren't really in this home. They weren't really welcome in the home, but they weren't able to come into the home. But you take us on this extraordinary journey, and you are an engaging guide. So thank you for that.
You.
And the Yellow House is out now. Wait, audience, you're going home with a copy. Hey there, GMA fans. Robin Roberts here. Thanks for checking out our YouTube channel. Lots of great stuff here. So go on, click the subscribe button right over here to get more of awesome videos and content from GMA every day, anytime. We thank you for watching, and we'll see you in the morning on GMA.